So you've been back, and you can still picture yourself there. Yet here you are in a college dorm room in the United States of America, living on a beautiful college campus. And that is such a contrast from where you guys came from. How hard is it to make that transition? How hard is it to know that there are family members, relatives, loved ones, and other children in your communities back home who are still living that way while you're sitting in a dorm room on a beautiful college campus? Was that difficult for you guys?
For me, yeah, I think it's very difficult, but I think that's something that I've learned growing up as a compassion child. Because, you know, the world always has a clear distinction between good times and bad times, between sorrow and joy. You know, there's always a distinction. But what I learned growing up as a compassion-sponsored child is that I've learned that in the eyes of God, it's never separated. When there is always, you know, when there is pain, there's always healing. Because I experienced that, you know, when my father left us when we were very young because he resorted into drug addiction because he cannot provide for our family. You know, I am experiencing the healing that the Lord is, you know, is putting into my family right now. That, you know, my father came back to us and, you know, we're taking care of him even if he is very sick. So, you know, they, right at the midst of your pain, there is always healing. And right in the midst of mourning, there's always dancing. Because, you know, as a little girl, I always cry. And, you know, like waiting for my father to, you know, to come back to us. Now that you know, that we can experience that, and we experience that through the loving Heavenly Father that we were introduced to, you know, in as a little girl in the Compassion Project, knowing that your Heavenly Father loves you so much.
You know, in Dr. Stafford's book, Too Small to Ignore, he talks about coming to the United States after growing up in West Africa and seeing a grocery store, a pharmacy that had all the drugs and prescription drugs, but the non-prescription drugs as well available, and so much food in the aisles, and that he was angry that, you know, why you guys have all of this here and there are people starving, there are people dying of preventable causes. Was there some anger when you guys came to the United States and saw what we have here and saw what's available? Or was it more of an appreciation? And tell me what you felt there.
When I came and I saw the differences among my between my country and the States, I just got encouraged to do something for my country so we can have access to those same things, very same things. I praise God for all the opportunities that God has given to America and all the blessing that they have received. But at the same time, I would like to have more of those in countries like mine, countries like Africa, and I mean, countries like Uganda and Kenya, not in the Philippines. Ah, no, in the Philippines too. You know, because it is okay to have things available. It is not bad, and I don't like Americans to feel guilty about it.
Yeah,
God has blessed them, and what I would like them to do is to appreciate and to see God in that same very specific situations, in all those blessings, that they could recognize that they didn't do a lot to take that. God gave them those. And I just want them to be thankful for the things that God has given them. And at the same time, I want to do something in my country so we can have access to those kind of things too.
That's great, Tony. Jimmy, did you want to say something there?
Yeah, I've just come from Kenya just the other day, last week. And when I got here, one of the things that really surprised me was people are so particular. You go to like a shop and you're like, which kind of coffee do you want? What kind of bread do you like? What kind of cheese? You know, all cocktail of varieties. What I don't know whether people here know is that back in our countries, sometimes it's have this or nothing, you know. But again, quickly, when I interrogate that, I come to realize that in the giving of the Americans, God has been able to bless them to have these varieties. You know, God has a whole package of blessings in giving. Bible has lots of texts that talks about giving. And I think I was not mad, only that to pray that God bring the same blessings back to our country through the people that are there. Like, for example, the host I'm staying with, they have this beautiful big house. Back in my country, that will be a house for politicians and ministers, really. You know, and being privileged to live in such serene environment, you know, and these people feel humble, you know, I wish that spirit went back to my country.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
And that the big men down there, and the big politicians and the millionaires in our country, if they had a heart like how the Americans have it,
mm-hmm.
I think we'll be far much better than what we are today. And
so
for me, I think I have a message for the rich people back in my country,
mm-hmm.
for what I've seen.
Mm-hmm.
That I'll use the expression or a quote by Winston Churchill.
Mm-hmm.
He said that the beauty of having is sharing the little you have with the ones don't have.
Amen. Mm-hmm. That's it.
That's right.
And so I love to tell that message in a very good contextualized way to my rich people back in the country,
mm-hmm.
that it's not about having this whole compound for yourself. It's not about having everything for yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Have you tried to give a little?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
In the same way, Jesus, this young man comes to Jesus and asks him, Lord, what do I need to do to be in the kingdom?
Mm-hmm.
And God, Jesus tells him, go sell everything, distribute to the poor. Yeah. And I don't know how that businessman was a businessman, because God, Jesus himself tells him, you'll get 10 times more.
Mm-hmm.
But the guy had a hard at. I don't know how astute a businessman that was, because if I was me, I'll immediately do that. You see?
Yeah.
And so that's a message I want to take back to the people who have in our country.
Mm-hmm.
Can you try to give a little of what you have?
Mm-hmm.
And God, just try God. Probably he's going to bless you with bigger than what you can imagine.
Mm-hmm.
And that was my first expression,
mm-hmm.
good message, take back to my rich people back in my country.
Yeah, I think I feel the same way about that, you know, some people always ask me that question, even my friends in Moody, you know, don't you feel any resentment about everything that we have here? And I tell them that this is what I've learned growing up, that it's about gratitude, you know, like a ministry that heals, a healing ministry will bring about gratitude to people, that their resentment, even if where they come from,
mm-hmm.
they will let go of that resentment because they feel that they are so, you know, blessed enough to, you know, to be having this. That ministry that heals, you know, particularly the ministry that we were involved at, you know,
mm-hmm.
as little children, is a ministry that will let people let go of resentment and experience, you know, and experience things that they're very little, but it made a huge impact in their lives. And that's what I think all of us, you know, share the same, you know, like we have the same heart when it comes to that we are so grateful already for what we have received, and we don't want to be resentful of our past, because anytime we can just tell everyone, you know, you shouldn't be wasting that, you know, water, or you shouldn't be wasting that food, but we cannot. Because we are experiencing this kind of, you know, of affluence now. You know, we can never call it affluence, but just this comfort that we are experiencing now, and just let go of all the resentment that, you know, the enemy can use that for you not to be grateful of who you are. And I think that's the problem in our country, that we always feel that we were deprived. You know, like leaders who are there in the positions right now in our country, they felt that all their lives they are so deprived. That's why it's our time to get everything, because they are not, you know, operating from a grateful heart. And that's something that it's very important for, I think, us who have lived in poverty to, you know, to just come across that message that we should be grateful enough, and that heart of gratitude will always remain in us, and let go of all resentment so that we can heal other people.